The Philippine Election Commission urging residents in Negros Oriental to participate in this year's village and youth polls or youth council polls. This even as nine mayors there are seeking the postponement of the said polls, citing security-related reasons. Governor Roel Dogamo was murdered earlier this year. The mayors believe the postponement would allow the national government to focus on ramping up security measures in the province. But the COMELEC asserts government is capable of ensuring public or make that ensuring safety during the elections.
So yung template po namin nung 2022 elections, dati po nung mga nakaraang halalan, ang violence po natin, election-related violence, umaabot sa 166. Merong panahon pa na 200 plus. Pero nakita po natin nung 2022 ay 27 election-related violence lamang po. This is the same template po na ipapatupad ng COMELEC ngayon. At baka igtingan pa nga po dahil alam naman natin iba yung dynamic spot, yung tempo ng eleksyon. Pagka magkakabarangay ang magtutunggali dahil magkakakilala sila, magkakapitbahay, minsan ay magkakamag-anak pa. Once and for all, gusto nilang matalikuran na yung ganitong buhay, ang eleksyon po ang unang hakbang patungo po dito.
COMELEC head George Garcia earlier said they are now 95% prepared for the village and youth council poll scheduled for October 30. Two are dead and several others wounded after government troops serving warrants against a local politician fought armed men in Maimbong Sulu Saturday morning. A member of the elite special action force was killed in that firefight, along with a member of a private armed group. 14 others on the government side were wounded. Authorities were attempting to serve warrants for murder and illegal possession of firearms and explosives against former Maimbong Vice Mayor Pando Mujasan, who was able to escape due to the firefight. Police say Mujasan is a commander of the Moro National Liberation Front. He is also accused of coddling and supporting members of the Abu Sayyaf group. The Alliance of Concerned Teachers set to file another case before the International Labor Organization over the alleged harassment of its members. ACT chairperson Vladimir Cueta says the June 14 memo of the Education Department instructing regional directors and schools division superintendents to submit a complete list of teachers affiliated with ACT will be on top of their complaint. Cueta calls that memo a systemic harassment of its members.
Hindi kami matatakot, no? Tuloy-tuloy yung aming pangangalagalampag. Hindi lamang sa bansa natin, kundi sa international na korte. Kasi kailangan marinig ito eh. Kasi ayaw nating maulit yung tuloy-tuloy na panlakot. At basically ito ay ayaw nating sikilin yung pag-uunyo natin.
The Education Department is strongly denying the harassment claims.
When this came out, it was really taken out of context in a way because we are not asking for a list of members of ACT or members of other organizations in general. We are only asking for those members that are availing of our APDS or automatic payroll deduction system. It cannot be profiling because we are not asking for new information here.
The Philippines expressing its gratitude to the United Arab Emirates that's following the pardon granted by the UAE to three convicted Filipinos, two of whom were in death row.
That just goes to show ang ating samahan, ating pagkakaibigan, at ang tiwala nila sa ating mga Pilipino na nagpunta dito at nagpursige at nag-contribute na rin sa pag-asenso ng UAE.
Nagpapasalamat kami sa pinagulan ng United Arab Emirates sa pagpapatawad nila sa tatlong mga Pilipino na nakatulong dito, including two from the death row. Ito nagpapatunay na tuloy pa rin na lalabanan natin ang karapatan ng ating magbabayad sa bansa.
President Marcos also called UAE President Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan to thank him personally. Marcos likewise invited Sheikh Mohammed to come to the Philippines. Well, after a bit of reprieve last week, motorists are again bracing for higher pump prices. Tuesday, kerosene prices will see the biggest jump at 1 peso and 20 centavos per liter. Diesel prices will also go up by a peso and 5 centavos per liter, while gasoline prices will see a 20 centavo hike. Industry players attribute the latest round of price hikes to Saudi Arabia's decision to cut oil production by 1 million barrels per day beginning next month. An environmental disaster expert says the Philippine government should invest in technologies that would beef up its response to oil spills. This as Department of Science and Technology scientist Dr. Hernando Bacosa slams the slow response to the oil spill in Oriental Mindoro. That disaster affected tens of thousands of fisherfolk, with the damage to the environment estimated at around 7 billion pesos.
Our capacity to respond was really slow. In the analysis of fish samples, it takes like more than 2 weeks to have the samples. So we have to invest on technology to analyze some samples, and we need to understand more. The science of oil spill is still very, very shallow in the Philippines. Like, we don't know what are these bacteria that are degrading the oil. We don't know how fast the oil can be degraded once it is transported from the deep sea to the surface, and then from the surface to the shoreline of the Calapan or Pola. And then we don't know how, I mean, what percent can be degraded by the oil. So we need to understand all these processes.
The fishing ban has been lifted in two towns that were affected by the massive oil spill in Oriental Mindoro. Dennis Tato now joins us with that story. Dennis.
Yes, Carmina, Oriental Mindoro Governor Bonz Dulor announced in a press conference this morning that a fishing ban in the towns of Nauhan and Pinamalayan has been lifted more than 100 days after the oil spill from the sunken MT Princess Empress, which carried over 800,000 liters of fuel. According to Governor Dulor, the decision to lift the fishing ban in those towns was based on a study conducted by the Department of Science and Technology and the recommendation of the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources. After the study showed that the level of oil and grease in the sea in those towns is now in acceptable level. However, the fishing ban and ban on water activities in the town of Pola will still remain because there has been an increase in the level of oil and grease within a 5-kilometer radius from the center where the MT Princess Empress sank. Along with this, Governor Dulor also announced that the ban on water and sport activities in the waters of Nauhan and Pinamalayan has been lifted. This means that tourism in the entire Oriental Mindoro, except for the town of Pola, can now resume in full swing. Governor Dulor said that the oil spill has affected the livelihood of over 31,000 families in Oriental Mindoro. Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources will conduct another examination in 1 to 2 weeks, and Governor Dulor hopes that the result will be favorable so that the fishing ban can be lifted, especially since the Philippine Coast Guard has previously stated that there's no more oil left in the tanks of the MT Princess Empress. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Dennis Dato, there joining us on the line. State volcanologists have recorded a significant increase in volcanic quakes coming from Mayon. Let's get an update now on the situation there from our very own Jose Carretero. Jose, over to you.
Carmina, Mayon volcano remains at alert level 3. For the past 24 hours, PVOLCS recorded 263 rockfall events and 8 pyroclastic density current, or PDC. The sulfur dioxide emission yesterday was measured at 925 tons per day. The volcanic quakes have significantly increased, according to PVOLCS. For the past 24 hours, PVOLCS recorded 102 volcanic quakes. But Mayon Volcano Observatory resident volcanologist Dr. Paul Alani said the earthquakes recorded are of low magnitude, which is not alarming yet. He said high numbers of volcanic quakes are expected as the volcano is still on alert level 3. What they are monitoring if these quakes will continue to increase and with high magnitude. A revised measurement of lava flow was released by PVOLCS in Misigali. From 2,500 meters, it was reduced to 1,300 meters. In Bumagali, the lava flow, according to PVOLCS, is 1,200 from the previous monitoring of 1,800 meters. PVOLCS explains the revision was done this weekend after the validation conducted by the agency using more advanced monitoring instruments. With the current status of Mayon, PVOLCS reiterates entering the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone is strictly prohibited as hazardous eruption is possible. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Jose Carretera there. Joining us on the line, four Mayon evacuees have now tested positive for COVID-19 and are currently under isolation. Albay's Emergency Management Office says several evacuees have also fallen ill due to unfavorable weather. It assures affected residents their teams are ready to respond to any health emergency.
Meron po tayong mga health team sa bawat evacuation centers at araw-araw po sila ay nagsasagawa ng health surveillance. Meron din tayong mga consultation na ginagawa upang kung sino man po ang may merong mararamdaman o may masamang pakiramdam ay mabibigyan agad ng lunas. Sa health surveillance, nakita po na isa sa pinakamataas na bilang ay yung mga sipon, ubo, o yung mga respiratory-related illnesses.
The rest of Mayon Volcano has forced around 20,000 people in Albay province to flee their homes.